In this screencast, I'm going to be showing you how to use message boxes in VBA. You can do a lot of interesting things with message boxes. Many of you have probably already worked with simple message boxes. The complete reference for a message box is shown here. We have a prompt, and that's just the text that's displayed in the message box, and obviously that's required. And then we have some optional things such as buttons, title, help file, and context. So buttons is something that you can customize. The default for these message boxes is just an OK button, but you can actually modify it however you'd like. The prompt items must be combined with an ampersand. Some examples. We have a message box, the answer is, and then we have a space before that first quotation, and space xval space and space tons in quotation marks, and we have a space before the tons. When we do that, it might give you something like this. The answer is 52 tons. And again, we have a space after the is and a space before the tons, and that makes sure that the 52 is not wedged right up against those two words. Another example, we have a message box. This is the first line, and we have this statement VBCRLF, and that's essentially a carriage return, and this is the second. So when we do that, it'll display this is the first line, and it moves that second part because we have that carriage return, it moves it to the second line. Now let's talk about how we can customize those buttons. Again, the default is a button code of 0. We can add different types of buttons. For example, having a yes and no would be a 4. So let me show you a couple of examples. I've got a simple sub made up here where we have a message box that's going to ask us if we want to continue, and I've got a button code here after the continue. Let me just show you what happens as we change this button code. So I'm going to run this. The buttons that come up are OK and cancel. You'll notice that the OK and cancel corresponds to that button code of 1. Now let's change this button code to a 3. And when we run this, that gives us 3 options, a yes, no, and a cancel. Now you may have noticed in the code that I just showed that I had answer equals message box. When we do that, the message box will actually provide an output, and that output is going to be stored in this variable answer. So we have to dim answer just like any other variable. The answer is another code, so it's kind of a separate code from the message box buttons codes. It corresponds to whatever the user clicked. So for example, if the user clicked OK in one of those message boxes, then the code corresponding to OK would be 1. And so answer would actually be the value 1. If I clicked abort, that would return a answer of 3, and so on. So let me show you a couple examples of this. Let me put in a 2 there. When I run this, my options are abort, retry, and ignore. Abort, retry, and ignore correspond to 3, 4, and 5. So if I click on the abort, that answer in the code will become a 3, retry will be a 4, and ignore will be a 5. So I will just press abort, and I want to show you this as I step through it. So I'm going to F8 through this. And if I click abort, we can bring up the locals window here. And abort was a 3, and you'll see that the answer down here now has a value of 3. And keep in mind that this is a string because the message box actually returns a string. So I'm going to keep going through this. I have a select case on the answer. Right now I don't have it set up, so it'll work with the cases that I have. But one thing you'll notice, I can do a select case either on a number or a VB yes, VB no, VB ignore, and so on. So let me show you an example of that. Let me restart this. I'm going to change this just to a simple yes, no, cancel, which is a 3. I'm going to do a select case on the answer. So remember, whatever button they push when this message box comes up, then that value is assigned to answer. So a yes is a 6, a no is a 7, and a cancel is actually a 2. So I'm going to do a select case on the answer. Case yes, I can put some code in here. So maybe you clicked yes, no, You click no, and then if I wanted to, I could actually add in here another case. So I'm going to step through this using F8. See, we have a yes, no, cancel. I'm going to click no, and when you look at this, the answer down here has a 7 assigned to it. You'll also notice that if I hover over the VB cancel, that's a 2, VB yes is a 6, and VB no is a 7. So that's another way you can kind of see what those correspond to. So I should skip over cancel, skip over yes, and go straight to no. And I say the message box, you clicked no. Another thing I want to show you is we can also do a case not just on VB cancel, but it's probably a little bit more intuitive to just use numbers. So I could use a 2 there, or I could use a 6 here, and a 7 here. And I rerun the code. This time I will select cancel, and you'll see that my answer is 2 there and also in the locals window. So I should go straight to you clicked cancel. So that's an easy way to customize the buttons in the message boxes.